finish.
Now that this JD is there, Varsha, what happens then?
So once the JD is there, and typically Madhuri will have to create these JDs for each role that she has. So for example, if the project, obviously, you know, the project leader, you saw the primary skills and the secondary skills will be different from the one that she has for her team members, right? So your application security engineer, primary skills, secondary skills will be different. So Ritesh takes a look at these job descriptions just to make sure he is understood. He might have some questions from Madhuri saying, okay, you've asked for this kind of experience. What if, you know, he doesn't have experience only in this, but also in this. So those are kind of questions that he will try and understand what the job description is about. And he creates a very short recruitment plan just for these 12 positions. He has an annual plan, but this is very specific for these. For this, just to make sure that he and Madhuri are aligned on what's going to happen.
So this is like a project, HR project. I mean, the HR itself has a project to recruit 12 people.
Absolutely. Yes.
And it has milestones. It has everything. It has its own things.
Right? Exactly. Exactly. Okay. And Ritesh basically is a project manager in that particular sense.
Or that project. Or that
recruitment. Yeah. And okay. He reports to Madhuri as his client.
Wonderful. Okay. Very clear.
Yeah, and the job description are basically like the specs, your project specs.
Right. And so this is actually, I understand now, Varsha. Basically, this is like a project plan now, you are saying.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So when he creates a project plan, he starts off with saying that, okay, these are the positions. And he will now talk about each position. Each position will get a number, saying project leader one, project leader two. Team member one, team member two, because each of these might have different primary skill, secondary skill requirements based on what Madhuri has said. So what the open position is, what is the timeline, which we spoke about in the indent. So the timeline comes from the indent. And what could be the channels of fulfillment? Now, what does channels of fulfillment really mean? Channels of fulfillment means, where is Ritesh going to hire these people from? Internal, maybe not happening because this is a growth. This is not an attrition, right? So this is, there are people, we need more people to be able to deliver this revenue. So we are going to look at people outside. When you look at people outside, that could be 4 or 5 channels that we're talking about in terms of where Ritesh could get candidate profiles from. The first one is, of course, publishing this particular thing on the company website and asking for applications. The second channel would be an employee referral channel, is what we call it. And this is where employees get a certain amount of money if they refer their friends, families to the for this particular post. Ritesh would also look at job portals, right? Like LinkedIn, like Naukri, and publish these jobs out there. Each of these portals, by the way, have some amount of money that they make by publishing these positions. So it all depends on whether, you know, these positions are budgeted, Ritesh has it in his budget or not. And Ritesh will also look for third-party consultants, saying that, okay, project leaders, I might not find profiles in my database, okay, from LinkedIn, from Naukri. So I will need specific third party consultants to be able to deliver that. One of the things that Ritesh can also do is organize a walk-in. This is very similar to actually putting up this position on the website, but this is a more physical form where people, where you know, the team members can get hired, and he can also look at fresher pool or the bench buffer that we spoke about for the team member positions that we have out here. So what does Ritesh really do? He has been tracking all the profiles. At the end of first week, he has gone only 5 applications. Now, if you look at the conversion rate, typically for every one position that needs to get closed, you need anywhere between 20 to 30 resumes to be sourced. before you can hire a candidate.
So we need 360 resumes.
Yes, you would need 360 resumes.
Good God.
Yeah, and the you know, and it becomes this funnel becomes even more difficult as your positions go higher. So your leadership is it's very difficult to get leadership resumes in the first part. And there your conversion rate could anywhere be between, you know, 8 resumes looked at and 1 person hired, but the time taken is much higher. So if you're hiring for a CEO or a CMO or a CXO, CTO of an organization, your hiring time is anywhere between 6 months to 9 months. And you might go through about 10 to 12 profiles because you have to headhunt them, as it's called. Mm-hmm. Right. So to be able to meet Madhuri's timelines, you can say 5 applications is nowhere near enough. 5 candidate resumes is nowhere near enough. So he wonders whether he should go to recruitment consultants. Remember, recruitment consultants, LinkedIn, Naukri, all of them take money. Right. There's no such thing as a free lunch. So he has to make sure, he has to analyze for the 10 members, should I go to a recruitment agency? Should I do a walk-in? Should I do another blast through LinkedIn? And this is what we call channels. And he has to figure out how effective is this channel. He has to look at the past data, figure out trends, figure out costs associated with each channel, and make sure that he has the best possible solution for Madhuri's hires.
So GV, it may be a good idea for us to sort of do a little bit of this channel analysis and see if we can come and present something to Varsha, right?
All right, correct. Understand, yeah, let us do that, yeah.
Yeah?
Okay, let's do that.
Let's do that and come back and present to Varsha.
Yeah.
Sure. So there'll be some historical data that'll be there, which, you know, you can analyze and then figure out which one works best for Ritesh and Madhuri.
Yeah.